Cord. Hi, everybody. This is UBC Yoga with Via, and today is April 25th, 2023. We're going to start in the usual fashion. The focus today is movements that help lower back pain. Let me say a little bit about that. So lower back pain has a lot of different causes and sources. So when you're dealing with movements, you're just trying, well, will this movement help? And, will that movement help? So if you have lower back issues, you can just ask yourself at each point, but all of the moves or most of the moves we are doing today will be addressing some forms of lower back pain. Okay, let's get started with static rest, which actually, by the way, is if you have no other thoughts in your mind when you have lower back issues, you could come into this static rest pose and it would be a gift to yourself. So, because, and I'll tell you why in a minute. Let's see if I can find. We're going to be here for 7 minutes. Static rest, and one of the first things it does is release the lower back and the psoas, both of which, lower back pain, psoas and lumbar releases. So here you are, and you could, in your daily life, if you couldn't think of anything else, you could stay here in a static rest pose for indefinitely, for up to an hour and benefit from it. We're going to be here for 7 minutes. Just watching your breath, trying to find a neutral position with your pelvis. Stay where you are. Put your tongue on the roof of your mouth, press it into the roof of your mouth to help exercise the chin muscles. And slowly move your head from right to left and back 6 times. And go ahead and finish up. Come back to center with your eyes open or closed. Vagus nerve reset. You're looking straight up to the ceiling. And your eyes are facing the ceiling. And now your eyes moving towards the right. Nothing else moves. Move toward the right. And wait for a sigh, swallow, yawn, or gulp. And come back to center, left, shift your eyeballs to the left, don't move anything else. And wait for a sigh, swallow, yawn, or gulp. Bring your head back to center and do this 2 more sets, right, left, without my cueing, at your own pace. Kathy's going to tell me when she's finished. That'll be our marker. Kathy's done, so finish up and get ready for head ramping. You may want to switch the pillow or the stack of towels under your head for a sponge ball. We're gonna do this 6 times. You're just gonna press. This is good for counteracting rounded shoulders and rounded head. Or cervical spine. Go ahead and press the occipital ridge back to the floor. Your chin drops a little bit. And then release. So push the head back into the sponge ball or the towel and the floor. Or if you're sitting up, just pressing back behind you. Hold. And then release. Let's do 4 more. Press, hold, release. 1 more. Press, hold, and release. Breath work. We're going to do Viloma breathing, one of my favorites. So Viloma breath is on your inhale, take three sips of breath of air to fill up the lungs, a third, a third, and a third, and then exhale and release all the way out normally, exhale normally. So five more of those. Inhale, 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 and exhale all the way out. Number three, inhale, 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 exhale all the way out. Four, inhale, 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 and exhale all the way out. I think this is about five. Inhale, 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 and exhale all the way out. Okay, the next thing and the last thing we're gonna do in the warm-ups is a vacuum. We're gonna do it three times. This is good for your back, by the way, good for lower back, good for strengthening. Anytime you can strengthen the core, which this is a core work. Anytime you can strengthen the core, you're going to improve your lower back strength and stability. And so on this one, I want you to take an inhale and an exhale all the way out. And then create a vacuum here. So put the back lies on the floor. So take the back towards the floor, the belly button towards the floor, and spread the rib cage and act as if you're going to take a breath and don't take a breath. And I'm going to count to 10. You got extra long this time. So stop if you need to. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And go ahead and release your breath and start to breathe normally. And then we'll do it again. Number two, inhale, exhale all the way out. Hold your breath out at the end of the breath, at the end of the exhale, no breath. Create a vacuum. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Inhale, breathe normally, exhale. And wait till your breath has returned to normal. And then we'll do number three, the last one. Take an inhale. Exhale all the way out. Hold your breath out and create a vacuum, no breath. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And normal inhale and a normal exhale. This is also a waist whittler. Core creates core, it's core work, it's a waist whittler. It does a lot of things, actually. Okay, now stay there and just take your, bend your knees and take your feet wide on the mat and drop your knees from side to side. Wide windshield wipers. This is just a transition to the next thing we're gonna do. And do this about six times. Six sets, right, left. When you're finished with six, bring your knees back, bent knees, feet on the floor. And we're going to do leg lifts. All of these hip movements are going to help you with your back. So leg lifts, starting on the right and then alternating to the left. And you just bring your knee up to towards your face, but to a 90 degree angle. And look at Kathy if you need a model. This is number two, set number two. Do these movements with awareness. Where am I moving? Where am I still? So the rest of your body should be still. You're not moving the hips or the torso. I've lost track of time. I think this is five. Good, Bia. And the last one is six. This is a fundamental hip movement. Let's go to next to knee drops to the outside. So you're going to drop your knee and drop it as far as you can without lifting the other hip. And then bring it back and do the other side. That's a set. Try to keep your hips and your torso still. You may not go as far, and that's okay. In fact, that's better. Because if you go too far, you're no longer doing abduction, adduction. You're doing some sort of a flexion. You're on five. That's okay. And then last one, six. Come on back. We're going to do what's called revolved abdominals. So you're lying on your back, you're pressing the back into the floor and lengthening the spine. And you're going to use your abs on this one. Open your arms out to shoulder height, palms down on the floor.
Oh.
On the floor. Palms down, straight out. Palms down, Kathy. Good. Now draw the chin towards the chest and allow the back of the neck to lengthen. You should probably be back on your towels or pillow, not on a sponge ball. And relax the shoulders away from the ears. Expand the breath in the chest. Inhale. And then exhale and drop both knees together towards the right. Keep the shoulders in contact with the floor. And then bring your knees back. Let's do this. You're really going to pull your knees towards your chest. So come up, yes, come up here and now go back to the left. So you're going to experiment as you go with how far, how close to have your knees to your chest. It's going to stretch different parts of your back. And
I can't do this, Shadow. I can't figure out how to do any of this. God damn it.
Who's this?
I don't know.
This is Rosemary Fiala. Fiala. Is she a friend of yours, Kathy?
No.
I think she came once before, but she's having trouble. Rosemary, if you're having trouble, do the best you can, and we can talk after class. So, and the other thing I want to say to people is if you want to make this harder, you can straighten your legs. And drop.
Oh.
It's much harder. Or you can come up just to a knee bent knee position. Come and so either way, your choice. You're always stretching the back, the lower back, and the mid back actually here. You're using your core. And let's do two more of those. And you should be feeling your core. Your core helps you come back up.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's get a therapy ball, one therapy ball out of the bag, either medium-sized or big. We're gonna put the ball under the glutes. One ball, one side. So you're on your knee, you're on your back with your knees bent, and put a therapy ball or a tennis ball if you don't have a therapy ball, or a rolled up sock if you don't have any balls at all. You're going to put it under your right hip. You're lying on the floor. And I want you to bring your knee, right knee, towards your face. And then bring it back down, foot on the floor. And extend your leg also. And come on back. And try it again. And now bring your right knee out to the right. And then come back to center. And out to the right. And come back to center. If you feel pain and it increases, your pain increases, I want you to stop what you're doing or find a different neighborhood to work in. So move your ball a little bit to the right, left, or up or down. And now come on back. And I want you to take your knee out to the right again. But as you do that, roll on the ball so that you are also your the ball is out to the right at the edge of your hip. This is just another way to release the glutes. And you probably will feel that. And you can actually come up onto your elbows and then take your knee all the way to the floor. And breathe. If it hurts and it doesn't subside as you work, then you really need to stop. Or, like I say, find another neighborhood. Let's go to the other side. You could spend a lot of time here. Well, more time than we have, you could spend here. thinking of ways to move. So here, coming up with your knee, your bent knee comes up towards your face, and then extend your leg, and then bring it back up, bend, come up, and then extend. And bend. And now bring your knee out to the right, to the left. So bend your knee, bring it out to the left, and then bring it back, and then out the left again. A couple more times. And now you're going to bring your knee out to the left and roll the ball out to the left. And you may want to come up onto your elbows so that you can really feel the movement here. So I'm up resting on my elbows. Maybe I should show you how that works. Since Kathy's not up. Let's see.
It's hard for her.
So she's not. I'm gonna. Whoops. You have to be on speaker to get both of us. I don't know. Here's what I'm going to do. Up around here. Up here, I'm up on my elbows or on my hands so I can move over the ball. Everybody see that? Or anybody see that? Just check it out here. And I'm finding a place when I drop my knee all the way down, a place that I really like for releasing tension. Listen to your own body when you're using therapy balls. It's a like an archaeological dig. Oh, I find this spot. Oh, I'm going to avoid that spot because it's too hard. Okay, remove your ball. I hope you get to go back to your balls, therapy balls, this week. And I want you, before we go on, I want you to, with your legs bent or your knees bent or your legs straight, I want you to do glute squeezes. So just like popcorn, you can do it, have set a rhythm for yourself. Right side, left side, both glutes at once. Actually, I'm finding it's easier to feel my glutes when I'm with have my knees bent. So the glute squeezes are really helpful for back, to have a strong back, because sometimes the reason, one of the reasons, contributing factors for lower back pain is glute weakness or glute amnesia, where your glutes aren't working. So you can actually do glute squeezes anywhere you are. You can do them sitting, standing, or on the floor like this. Okay, let's finish up with that and do our floor seated, cross-legged spine twist and side bends and hip hinge. So starting, this is going to be for 40 minutes.
40 minutes?
40 seconds. Sorry. 40 seconds. Just take your right hand out. Take your left arm up above you. For the first half, we're just going to breathe and side bend. Keep your hips on the floor. You can move your head from left to right if you want. You could put your tongue on the roof of your mouth if you want. And now go ahead and move your top arm up out in front of you so that you can add a latissimus dorsi stretch. You feel this in the armpit and along the back, side of the back. And slowly lift your arm up and then lift your torso up and come to the other side. Left hand, right slides along the mat, right arm up and over. Seconds. Bring your right arm, your top arm forward, create an additional stretch. And slowly take your top arm up and then your torso up. Switch the cross of your legs. We're going to do a spine twist. Put your left hand on your right knee. Put your right arm behind you and rotate to the right. While you're here, sit tall. If you want to, you can add These are optional add-ons, but you can move your head from right to left, or you can move your torso from right to left. And slowly unravel and come to the other side. Right hand on left knee, left arm behind you, sit tall, rotate to the left, spinal twist or thoracic rotation. And while you're here, you could do the add-ons that I mentioned before. And slowly unravel and come on back. The next thing we're going to do is a stacked knee wrist twist. So I love the stacked knee position, and it does a lot of things to open up the sacrum and the hips. So you're going to take one knee forward and the other knee stacked on top of it also forward. Or do the best you can. Some people need to sit on something, sit on a pillow or a cushion or a brick to do this. Hands, wrist twist. So bring your arms out in front of you and take your right hand up. Let's see. Oh, the hands are back, facing backwards. The back of the hands touching. Take your right hand up and then over. Interlace your fingers and start bringing your hands. This is the wrist twist up towards your chin. I'm going to have to get out of it to start the timing. And sit tall and just know this is a whole body movement. It works on the upper body and the lower body. If you can't get it this far, you can do it, do your best. This is a do your best pose, as are all of them, actually. And slowly unravel and uncross your knees and switch to the other side. Ooh, maybe I can't do this one today. I'm getting a cramp up here. Yeah, I'm going to do some modified version of this about here. I guess I can do it without cramping. All right. Hands out in front of you. The back of the hands touching each other. The left hand raises and comes around and clasps the right hand. And then you bring your arms up towards your chin. Stay here. I'm going to have to undo that to set my timer. Yeah, I can't do both of my legs at once today because I'm getting got a cramp in my left hip. Sit tall. Breathe, become aware of what's moving or what was moving and what's not moving. And slowly unravel and shake your hands. And go ahead, let's go ahead and come up to standing with a brick. We're going to do a pendulum, what's called a boomerang and a hip hinge and a pendulum all on the brick. So you're standing beside a wall with a brick. And stand on the brick. So the inside wall, the inside foot, the inside leg is standing on a brick. I like a hybrid, which you should decide for yourself. Now, let's see what he's doing. I'm going to take my picture away because you don't need to see me do this. Remove spotlight. There. So you're the outside. So the first thing we're going to do is boomerang, which is a side bend. You're going to cross your left ankle over your right, and then put one hand, your inside hand on the wall, and then bring your other hand arm up and over.
Now it's hard for, I don't have a very big room, so bear with me.
Okay, so maybe you won't be able to see Kathy's feet, but you'll be able to see her arm. Okay, but she's standing on a brick and then crossing the one ankle over the other, and then her other arm comes up and over and hopefully touches the wall, but it may not. So just do the best you can. This is a side bend of, it's called a boomerang side bend. And come on out of that. And the next thing we're going to do is hip hike. So standing on the brick, and then just hiking the other opposite hip up. You can put your hand on the wall for stability and just hike up and do this 6 times. So one of the things that can be create some back issues is if your muscles here at the waist are weak. So we're working with that muscle. And come up and try to keep the other side down so it's just the one side, and finish up. And the last thing we're going to do is pendulum, which I love for releasing tension in the hips. And you're still going to stand on the brick and you're just going to swing your leg back and forth. It's not really there's not a lot of effort. It's a pendulum. You're dangling, and we're going to dangle for 40 seconds. Dangle back and forth, back and forth. Allow the head of the femur, which sits in the pelvis here, to move with a lot of space, in a lot of space. Just releasing, finding space, more space in the hip joint may help your lower back. And now go to the other side. So face the other direction. And the first thing we're going to do
is the boomerang or the side bend at the wall, standing on a brick. Stand on that brick with your left foot this time. One hand on the wall, cross your right ankle in front of your left, and take your right arm up and over. See if we can be here for 40 seconds. Get your best side bend, assisted by the brick, the crossed ankles, and the wall. Breathe. Be aware of what's moving, what's lengthening, what's compressing. And slowly come out of that, come all the way out, stay on the brick, hip hikes. So just lift the right hip. So you can put your hand at the top of the outside of the hip and press up. Press up into your armpit or into your finger also. Let's do this 6 times. And when you're finished, start to dangle and swing your leg, the one that's not standing on the brick. That's why I like, Diana, that's why I like to have the higher brick, actually. The dangle has more room. And you're just going to swing back and forth very gently. No big effort. Not swinging way forward or way back, just dangling, allowing and creating space in the hip joint, which can improve your lower back. Give more space there. All right, come out of that, come off of your brick. And let's do the, let's come back down to the floor with a strap. We're going to do the leg stretch 1, 2, and 3. This time, you're going to have both legs at the wall, and you need room on either side for your, and I'm going to need to go get a strap here. So your legs are both going to be at the wall, tucked into the corner of the wall, and then you're going to bring, and you may want to put your head on a brick or some washcloths. Take your right leg up toward the ceiling. Put a strap around the instep. Hold on to the strap. Drop your elbows so that you're not using your arms. You're not struggling with your arms. The elbows are down, and we're going to stay here for 40 seconds. The legs should be straight or almost straight, depending on how much tightness you have in your hamstring. Stay here and breathe. You don't have a strap, a yoga strap. First of all, you should get one to continue in this class, and or you could use a bathroom strap, bathrobe strap, or something else, even a towel. Okay, leg stretch number 2. Put your both straps in your right hand. Keep your hips on the floor. Take your left hand out, straight out, to provide balance
for this movement, and then take drop your right hip, right, your right leg to towards the floor, out to the right. And don't, you can look at Kathy, but your leg may not go down as far as Kathy's does, due to skeleton, maybe some due to flexibility, but also maybe skeletal.
It's hereditary. Yeah.
So just know, do your best, keep both hips on the floor. And breathe. And feel and enjoy the stretch. You might want to put your right leg as it comes out onto a chair or a brick. Instead of letting it dangle. So your left foot is pressing against the wall as if you were walking on it. Okay, come on up, bring your right leg up and over. So you're gonna take the strap in your left hand, and then you're gonna take your right leg over, and you're gonna actually roll this time. So the bottom foot is, the outside edge of the foot is on the floor, and you've stacked your hips, and here you are, and you could be putting your right leg on a brick or a chair instead of letting it dangle. Your choice. And you can take your right arm out to the right to help with this. This is a great spine twist. Keep your shoulders on the floor and a hip stretch or a leg stretch. And slowly come back, and we're going to start all over on the other side. So take your strap, put it around your left instep, straighten your leg up toward the ceiling, that left leg, press your right leg into the wall, and we'll wait, hold here for 40 seconds. Remember, your leg can be straight or almost straight. Your left leg, and your right leg is pressing into the wall and the floor, as if you're standing on it. Okay, put both straps in your left hand and take your leg out to the left. Your left leg out to the left. You can take your right arm out, straight out along the floor. Keep your hips on the floor. You may want to put your left leg on a chair, nearby chair, or a brick or two bricks. Don't go any farther than squared hips on the floor allows. Okay, come on back. Put your straps in your right hand. Roll your left leg across your body to the right, and you're going to shift the position of your foot and your hips. So your hips are stacked, and your foot, the outside edge of your foot, is now on the floor.
You may put your left arm out behind you. Press your right foot into the wall as if you're standing on it. And slowly come back and release your strap and bend your knees and rock from wide knees, walk from rock from side to side. Just a transition to our next movement, which is the Yoga Nidra 61 point guided meditation. So we're going to get ready for that as soon as you've loosened your hips a little here. Okay, find your way on while you're on your back. Continue to be on your back. Make sure you are comfortable and you feel safe and warm or cool. If you're living in a hot temperature, maybe you'll want to try to find some cool. I'm going to take you through 61 points on your body with your mind. So I'd like you to take your mind, let your mind travel with my words. Don't move though. This is a what's called Yoga Nidra meditation. First, bring your awareness to your breath and observe how your abdomen rises and falls as you breathe in and out. Now bring your awareness and your attention to the center of your eyebrows, center of your throat, right shoulder, elbow, wrist, right thumb, second finger, third finger, fourth finger, fifth finger, right wrist, elbow, shoulder, center of your throat, left shoulder, elbow, wrist, left thumb, second finger, third finger, fourth finger, fifth finger, left wrist, elbow, shoulder, center of your throat, spiritual heart center, right side of your chest, heart center, left side of your chest, heart center, navel center, center of your pelvis, right hip, knee, ankle, right big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe, right ankle, knee, hip, center of your pelvis, left hip, knee, ankle, left big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe, left ankle, knee, hip, center of your pelvis, navel center, heart center, center of your throat, center of your eyebrows. This completes your 61 point guided meditation. Go ahead and extend your legs and extend your arms over your head by your ears and stretch your body in both directions, left side, right side, both sides. Stretch, stretch, stretch. And then wiggle your fingers and your toes. And rotate or circle your wrists and your fingers, wrists and your ankles in one direction and then the other.
And hug your right knee to your chest. Thank you, knee. And slide your right leg along the floor. And hug your left knee to your chest. Thank you, knee. And then slide your left leg along the mat. Go ahead and hug both knees to your chest and rock from side to side. This is a great movement for releasing the lower back. And rock from side to side until you're ready to come into a side lying position on the floor with your head on a pillow or your arm. And this is our gratitude second. Let me find the gratitude minute. Let me find my timer. Come on. There. I'm just going to stay here. It's a time to reflect on what you're grateful for. Thank you for coming to this class. I'm grateful for you for sharing my practice with me. Next Saturday, I'll be 81. So I'm celebrating a birthday. I'm not celebrating in the same fashion I celebrated my 80th, but grateful to be here, grateful to be moving. Come on up, you guys, to a floor-seated position. I'm going to remove the spotlight. We're going to close the class with namaste. I'm going to switch it to a gallery view so I can see all of you and you can see all of me. Well, wait a minute. I have to turn my video on.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Put your hands, bring your hands together in prayer pose. Press strongly. See if you can find any upper back. So you see if you can talk to your your hands can talk to your upper back. And then release that and just make it softer. And lift the occipital ridge up away from the shoulders so you can roll forward, slide forward. The skull slides over the top of the cervical spine, C1, C2. And just nodding and bowing and knowing that we're all one light and that we are also individual lights that make up the one light. And we're going to close the class by saying to each other, namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you, everyone.
And thank you,
Mom.
Thank you, Vivia. Good class.